In this vlog, we will continue with the concept of Flutter hooks and try to see the useCallback Flutter hook. So, as a part of this tutorial, we are going to deal with a few concepts like memoization, which we have dealt earlier in this series, but we'll try to just recap what is memoization. Then we will dive into useMemoized hook and later, of course, useCallback. So we will try to compare the differences between useMemoized and useCallback in this part of this tutorial, so that if you are a beginner, there will be a quite confusion between useMemoized and useCallback, because on a top level, both of them appear to be same. So we will dive deep into the concept and try to understand it. Stay till end of this tutorial to get a very good knowledge on what is useMemoized and useCallback. So now let's get started. Let us try to recap what is memoization. So in our previous tutorials also, we have made use of this particular concept. So if you have not gone through that particular tutorial, here is a link for the tutorial, you may visit it. Memoization plays a crucial role in both the hooks, that is useMemoized and useCallback. This is a very important concept, because in both these hooks, we will try to cache the data here. So in one of the hooks, we will try to cache the end result, and in another hook, we will try to cache the entire function. So what is what? Let's try to see it. Memoization is caches the value of function. Just now we have discussed, right? So memoization will try to cache the value or the function. So in both these hooks, like useMemoized and useCallback, we will try to implement this particular concept, memoization. In both these particular hooks, useMemoized and useCallback, the backend thing is the same, that is maintaining the cache. Okay, so when the function is first run, it will store the result rather than running it multiple times. It's the same vice versa with the useCallback. So when the function is run, it will try to store the entire function and it will try to process it. This is a basic recap of memoization. There is a lot to see in this particular concept of memoization. So do visit this particular link, which I have provided in the description section below, to get more information on this particular concept. As a part of this tutorial, I'm just giving you a bit of small recap. That's all. Next, try to see what is a referential equality. So let's try to get the intro to this particular concept of referential equality, so that you will try to understand useCallbacks. When A points to C and B points to C, then there exists referential equality. So are you confused? Going through this line for a beginner might be quite confusing. So what is like A points to C and B points to C? So now let's try to see an example here. When A equal to 10 and B equal to 10, then there doesn't exist a referential equality. So don't get confused, I will explain. So when A equal to C and B equal to C, then that is a referential equality exists. Okay, so they are considered to be equal based on the locations, not value. So according to the second point, referential equality states that A equal to C, so A is pointing to C and B is pointing to C. So the variable C memory location is same in both the cases. So when A is pointing to C and B is pointing to C, then there exists a referential equality. So what does that mean? What does that mean is, like in our useCallback, we are trying to cache the entire function, and every time you are trying to make use of the same function. So there we are making use of this particular referential equality concept and making use of that particular mechanism. Whenever there is any change, then differential equality doesn't exist in that particular condition, like as we have seen in our first example here. So don't get confused. In our next slide, you will be getting a good clarity on both the useMemoized and useCallbacks. So useCallback will provide us referential equality between renders. So just now we have discussed, like, referential equality is being used in our useCallback hook here to maintain the cache of the function. Let's try to see the basic differences of both useMemoized and useCallback. So both of them will try to provide caching mechanism. Okay, so this is very clear. Both of them will try to provide you the same caching mechanism. The difference is, so how exactly they differ in providing the cache? Result of the function is being cached in terms of useMemoized. For example, consider there is a function which will try to add two numbers, for example a plus b, and trying to store the result in another variable c. So in terms of useMemoized, we will try to cache the final result, that is c here. For example, you're trying to pass 1 plus 2 as a parameters to this particular function, and you're trying to add them, and you will get the result like 3 here. So every time you try to provide 1 plus 2 as a parameter to that particular function, so every time you will be getting 3 as an output, right? So in this useMemoized concept, it will try to run the function for the first time and will calculate the result to be 3 here. And every next time when you try to call that particular function, it will try to fetch the result directly rather than calculating it again and again. So the same concept but in a different way in useCallback, this will remember the function. So it doesn't remember the value, but it remembers the function. So whenever you try to pass the same function here, so it will try to provide you with the final result there. So don't get confused here. In the first one, in the useMemoized, we are trying to store the final result. In the useCallback, we are trying to cache the entire function here. So whenever the same function is being repeated, then it will try to maintain the instance rather than recreating it. Okay, we'll get back the stored output every time rather than calling the function. We'll remember the function provided and process it. So this is what we have just discussed. May change once the dependencies vary. So this is the same point in both the cases. In the coming slide, we will be trying to see the syntax. There you will be getting an idea of this particular fourth point, like how it will vary and how it will vary depending upon the dependencies here. There might be one more question for you. Okay, by making use of useMemoized and useCallback, we are trying to cache the function or cache the value and trying to make use of it every time we try to call that particular function. But what if there is any change? What if you are trying to pass 2 plus 3 instead of 1 plus 2 every time? So you are trying to pass 1 plus 2 and you are getting 3 as an output, that is good. So the next time when you try to pass 2 plus 3, what will be going on? So how will it be processed? To answer this particular question, we'll try to see the syntax of useMemoized here and as well useCallback. So here you can try to see almost all there is a similarity between both of them. Both of them try to accept a function and array of dependencies here. You can find the key here. Both of the functions have a key here as specified. So there you can specify the change. If there is any change, you can just specify the keys in this particular array. And whenever there is any change notified, then our function will rerun again. So whenever you are trying to make change in the inputs, then that will be notified with the help of this key here, and it will try to rerun the function, and which will result in a new output for you. So again, there are also few drawbacks for using this particular concept, because every time you are maintaining a cache and there will be a memory storage, and there also you need to maintain some memory even for these functions to store their cache every time. Okay, so that is a major drawback you can observe here. Why? Because whenever there is any large function, then it will require a lot of memory for storing, that is for caching every time. Why? Because you are trying to pass 1 plus 2 and got result 3. Next time you have got 2 plus 3 and you have got result 5. And again for the third time you try to pass 1 plus 2. Then it will fetch the stored cache value rather than recalculating it. So in this particular scenario, try to just imagine how many times you need to make use of this particular concept. That is, how many times you need to cache the function or the value. Make sure you try to use this particular hooks whenever there is any requirement, especially whenever you feel there is a much requirement for maintaining cache. And again, depending upon the complexity of the function, try to choose in between these two things like useMemoized or useCallback hooks. So this is what the just basic overview I would like to give you on these two particular hooks. So if you are having any query in this particular tutorial, do let me know in the comment section below. And for more interesting tutorials on Flutter, do like, share and subscribe to our channel.